Hello and welcome to another video where I summarise a part of the OCR A-level psychology syllabus. This video is about component three, and in particular the topic of collection and processing of forensic evidence in criminal psychology. There's three parts to this topic, like there are any criminal topic, part A, which is about research and the findings, part B, which is about issues and debates, and part C, which is about applications. This video is going to hopefully do all three of those in about 2 minutes, starting on the next slide. This intro doesn't count for anyone getting really, really picky. Let's start the timer and see how we get on. So the key research in this area is Hall and Player. It was a field experiment with an independent measures design. 70 fingerprint analysts were given details of a crime, either low emotional context or high emotional context, so a non-violent crime and a violent crime, and then they were asked to make a judgment on whether the fingerprint matched or not. What they found was two things in this study. First of all, the emotional context, the severity of the case, did seem to cause some cognitive biases in the analysts. 52% of participants in the high context condition felt affected by the crime, and only 6% of the low context did. However, the other conclusion, in the case of expert analysis, emotional effects didn't cause any errors in judgment. There wasn't a significant difference between identification rates, which therefore tells us, on the whole, that experts don't really take into account context of the crime, and some of them didn't actually even read it. So, issues and debates in this area. It is useful. It offers solutions to remove bias in forensic testing. More on that in a second. It's also holistic because it looks at lots of different factors as a cause of bias. Things like cognition, details. It's very scientific. It uses a standardized technique in the research, but also there are standardized techniques in forensic analysis as a whole. So we can talk about control and objectivity and replicability. Determinism is a problem. Early research assumes that emotional state does affect our ability. However, Hall and Player's study doesn't necessarily back that up, saying we've got more free will than we think we do in cases like this. And there are methodological issues in the research, such as sampling bias, ethnocentrism, reliability, ethics, and validity. In Hall and Player knew they were taking part in an experiment that might cause demand characteristics. Two applications here. The first is something called blinding precautions, where a fingerprint analyst is only given essential information, which means that they aren't susceptible to things like confirmation bias or other cognitive biases. The other approach is something called the ACE-V approach, which stands for Analysis, Comparison, Evaluation, Verification. And this works by introducing more standardization into the process and reduces the impact of context, therefore making analysis a little bit more structured and effective. That was 2:02 as a summary. Just while I've got you here, a couple of study notes and study tips and things you can use in a question. For part C questions, make sure you explain how they would work. Put a bit of psychology in there, like cognitive biases or replicability in this case. For part B, the key skill is obviously pushing your answer forward, so therefore and because. And if you can, get some however in there, some discussion. You might have learned about PE points as opposed to PEE points. Also, if you want a top band answer for a part B question, you need to be trying to include more than one study in your answers. So you could include research like Draw et al, who did a kind of Hall and Player thing, but with students as opposed to expert analysts, and they found different results. That creates a problem and a methodological issue. Hope those things help. As I go through these videos, there will probably be some more study tips and study information that we can put in. But until then, let me know if you've got any other questions or comments in the comments. If you like this video, there's a button specifically for that. And if there's anything else you'd like me to try and get my teeth into, then let me know. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Cheers.